Into Zandvoort! A track I'm not good at, but that's the thing about the season. I want to challenge myself, not only against a superior driver, but also on tracks that I'm not good at. Unfortunately, that really helps, doesn't it? That's a great start, that. Not going to have the advantage of having a clear field to start.
Right, get ready to jump out if you get too hot in there. There's a problem with the cooling system and it's going to take us a few minutes to correct it.
Climatization. Just got to get the gates, no time limits. Not going to get all purples, but I'm hoping to get majority purples and minimum greens, and we should be fine. There's no one behind me, that's good. I can slow down a little bit. This would have been perfect for racing line objective. Because you've got to stay on the line really to get these corners. Concentrating so hard on this. Yes! 100% purple! Love that. 5 out of 5. That's a good start. So come on back to the garage and I can take you through the numbers. Right, tire management, I guess, and then we'll focus on race strategy, which takes at least 3 laps. Definitely not getting Delta.
Time Delta back into the green, we'll need to rerun the program.
Shut up. look, I tried, alright? I got low tyre wear. Just because I didn't make the time doesn't mean I didn't get low tyre wear. I got it in the purple. It should count for at least a yellow. Come on. Anyway, race strategy, let's go. Not doing that again. My word, mate. Oh, for God's sake. Well, at least Schumacher's fast, that is the guy ahead of him.
Okay, we need a few solid laps here to help us calculate a good race strategy.
How is he faster? He's not even got the fourth fastest car, bro. I got speed trap. Schumacher's having trouble as well. Just whether that is too crowded. Take me back to acclimatization. Have me do that for 10 laps. I've had enough. Imagine that I failed to do this. Takes up a whole session to those things. Thank you. Just had to think a little bit. Just get in the zone. We're gonna smash this lap. Belgium was our weekend. Let's make this our weekend too. Who on earth is second? It's me now. No, it's not anymore. Who was that? Even Leclerc Verstappen, surely.
With qualifying finished,
Leclerc. Interesting. 36 laps and it involves rain. Just great, that ain't it? Just fantastic. I hope it's one of those races where it starts dry and it might not rain for the whole race. And it starts raining like with 5 laps to go, then it's not so bad. So if it's like that, then I'll definitely take it. Okay, it's sunny at the start. That's a good sign. That's a good sign.
Zandvoort circuit. We're 25 miles away from Amsterdam for today's Dutch Grand Prix. It's a race the great Jim Clark won on 4 occasions. leading for an astonishing total of 370 laps. Zandvoort Circuit has 14 corners, 10 to the right and 4 to the left, with plenty of steep camber and elevation changes to keep our drivers on their toes throughout the 2.6-mile lap. Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Michael Schumacher lines up on pole position, with Charles Leclerc alongside. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Davidson, Sainz, Lando Norris, and Verstappen, Ricciardo, Russell, Hamilton, and Valtteri Bottas, Ocon, Oscar Piastri, Alex Albon, and Latifi, Mick Schumacher, Magnussen, Guan Yu Zhou, and Pierre Gasly, Tsunoda, Vettel, Stroll, and Daniel Tickton. With preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track. Natalie Binkham joins me once again in the commentary box. It's fantastic to have you with us today. I'm curious though, how do you think the drivers stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, I imagine they'll be starting to feel the adrenaline as they anticipate the
bit of dirt on my wheel.
One. A bit like preparing to go into
battle. If I lose, it's because of that.
The unknown situation will bring nerves, but that's a good thing. It'll keep them focused on the moment and on their surroundings as we build towards
trying
the
to scratch
start
it off.
Of the Grand Prix.
Some of it scratched off. Yeah, screw it. We'll do that.
The formation lap gets underway and every driver will be looking to settle in for the race ahead, making sure that their car is ready for the battle.
Early Magnussen and Tsunoda on mediums. Okay.
So as all the cars reform the grid, the drivers will be hoping to get a strong start. They'll want to earn some valuable points from today's race, with final communications being done with their race engineers, ensuring the planned strategies are all in place.
I get that. I'm obsessed with getting the perfect screenshot. I never use it for thumbnails either. I love to see this on YouTube. I don't do a thumbnail. I just let YouTube decide the thumbnail. But I still get these great pictures, and I posted this one on Twitter just to show off. Like, oh, look at this cool game. I like this. This is what I play. Mag's already a second ahead of me. Like, my word, mate, relax. Thank you.
1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone.
It's a DRS lap, so not getting enough of a lead on Leclerc. So instead, I'm going to have to deal with Leclerc, Sainz and Verstappen all having DRS on me, despite two of them being over a second behind. But because Leclerc is close enough to them, now we've got this issue. Guess I'm going to do what I did. Which track was that? I can't remember. It wasn't Monaco, was it? It was another track. There was a track where I was defending for Michael. Like, I was holding second so he can get the win. Maybe that was Coulthard last season, I can't remember. Excuse me. Hate this bloody turn. That turn was a nightmare for me in F1 2021. Somehow I haven't spun out on that yet in this game. Just playing a bit more would help. Be holding off for Schumacher then. That's the plan.
Okay, you're sat in P2. Okay, Michael's ahead of you. Okay, gaps of the car ahead is 3.9 seconds. Okay, they're on old softs. Leclerc behind. Okay, the gap is less than a second. Okay, they're on old softs.
Stop saying okay.
Alright, 31 laps to go now.
He said alright instead. At least he listened to me.
Dropping back by about 3/10 a lap. Well done.
You say that as he gains 2 tenths back. Purple logo doesn't stand out, does it? It looks cool, but you need the sun to really shine for it to actually, like, you know, you need to see it, like, properly see it. We are a quarter of the way through the race. It already looks like we know who's going to win the race. It's quite clear that, you know, you've got the best team, Lamborghini, and then you've got Ferrari, who seems to be second best, and then you've got Red Bull, which is mainly Verstappen, because Latifi's his teammate, and obviously he's not going to perform well. But Verstappen has got, you know, winning speed. And I guess because of the regulation changes, neither of those teams hit the ground running. But now they're really starting to look like they'll be competitive with me, at least. Not with Michael, though. Because as you can see, Michael is not here.
Mediums.
Someone's burned out. It's Michael, isn't it? No, it's not. Who is it? Who's laying down? Oh, it's Verstappen. Verstappen, he's out of position.
Okay, information on Verstappen. Okay, they're out of this race.
Maybe I should sign him. I wanna switch driver, switch teammate every season. I've been going for legends all this time. I went for Button, then Villeneuve, then Coulthard, now Schumacher. Maybe I should go for someone who's a current driver. Would Vettel be cheating? Yes, it would. But if I could get like Verstappen or Leclerc, it'd probably be quite expensive though. Lewis as well, he'd be expensive. I want someone who I know can win a championship. Because I want the challenge. And I just think of those three drivers on the current grid. Alonso would be pretty... I think he's retired off the game though, but still. Leclerc is lapping faster than me at the moment, which is a bit scary. I thought Norris might have had pace with his qualifying position and all, but he's still far off the pace of the Ferraris and us. Alright, we're pitting same as Leclerc, that's good. Sign's going on hards. We're going on mediums.
Achieve the fastest pit stop time possible. Pit strategy complete. See these tires through to the end now.
And no cars just in the middle of us, damn it. That would have been good. For a master plan. I don't know how we gain times in the pits. Like, I don't know what exactly we do to gain time in the pits, but we always do it. And we pitted at the same time as Leclerc, but we gained like half a second of it. He has game time back straight away though, so shows how good I am at this track. I'm a success. You did start on medium, so you'd expect it to be that high. He's not though, is he? He's gaining it back. He has a few bad corners and he's banging it. They hit the grass there. Good, I freeze them this race. Fifth, I see. It's signs as fully backed off. Probably because he went on hard. Halfway through the race. Less within range of the race. I don't know what happened to Charles, but for some reason he's a second behind. I don't know since when, but he is. I normally gain a lot of time on corners, but those corners, never. I did gain a little bit there though, but I lose it again, see? Okay, I actually done well there. To be fair. It's interesting how they pitted Sainz just a lap earlier than Leclerc, just one lap difference. But they put Sainz on hards and Leclerc on mediums. Just Ferrari things. They could be experimenting, but also It could just be Ferrari-ing it.
The car behind is dropping back by about 3/10 a lap. Well done.
Every time this guy speaks, something bad happens. So like my driver locks up. I just get a vibration in my wheel on that on turn one. That feels like a lock up. Two-thirds of the race done. See there, on that, right at the end of that turn, that steering wheel goes back left again so suddenly. It's annoying. Only some turns do that for me. Turn here, and then it goes left there. I get that vibration like right in the end of that corner. I don't even get it here, so I get it on that corner though. Let me guess, Michael's about to lap someone, yep. Right behind the Williams. And he's lapped to Williams. That poor Williams. Chief. Excuse me. Good on saying excuse me for yawning. I don't think that's the correct saying for yawning in front of someone. What is the correct saying? I don't know. Three quarters of the race done. Still no rain. I don't know why my eyes are a bit watery. It's weird, like before the stream started I was fine. But now I am actually very tired. Tiredness like that, I guess. It just kicks in. Guess I did work all day today, but I didn't feel that tired after work. Again, I guess I just feel it maybe just kicks in at some point during the night. It has kicked in for me. Which is not great, because I plan to do three races today, and this is the first. We'll be fine, we'll be fine. We have done 5/6 of the race. I love my fractions today. Get ready for an extraction, lads and ladies. I've got a big whopper. Oh, we could lap someone. Yes. Oh my god, look how many cars Schumacher's lapped. He's lapped 10 cars. We have done 8 ninths of the race, my friend. 8 ninths. My friend, my friends. There's 1 ninth to go. Wait, there's an extraction.
We're expecting some rain soon. Expect the first drops in the next few minutes.
No one's gonna pit them. Get some DRS, boy. Did you get DRS? I don't even know. Alright, let's go out of the path through. I'd like to think that helped look up a little bit, but I don't think it did. I think Schumacher's left 11 cars. And he's eyeing up a 12. And while I was saying all that, I forgot to say 2 laps ago that we have done 11 twelfths of the race. Thank you. seemed like it was about 12 cars. We have done 35, 36 of the race. Just 1/36 left. Sebastian, how you doing, sir? Take that, considering it could have rained, and it didn't rain.
Not just victory today then, but the championship as well. What a spectacular season they've had. Congratulations to the whole team. Natalie Pinkham, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
They certainly stood out as a driver with tons of confidence on the track. I think their ability to keep their cool, even during some of the more hectic parts of the race, meant they were able to capitalize on the mistakes of other drivers, giving them the opportunity to make their way to the top spot with ease.
To an incredible Grand Prix weekend. Our top three finishers should be incredibly happy with what they were able to achieve out there today.
Alrighty then.
So let's see what effect this result has had on the driver's standings. A solid result for Michael Schumacher, extending his lead and bringing the championship title that much closer. So then, Natalie Pinkham, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Today, I think I'll give it to the Haas driver.
Nothing can challenge the leaders in the construction.
The Haas driver, is that what it's reduced to? What? With that result, Mick Schumacher, I would assume.
No longer be touched at the top of the table. What an incredible journey this has been for a team many had written off a short time ago. They are the Formula One world champions. There was also a strong showing from the McLaren team today as they make their way up the standings. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time out?
Well, we'll find out. I think it might be Monza next. Go.